Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to today's video. Now, in this video I'm going to show you a process called cross-polarisation. Now, you may be aware that if you're shooting outdoors and you want to reduce reflections from water or trees and leaves, etc., you use a circular polarising filter on your lens. And if the sun is at 90 degrees to your camera axis, you'll get maximum cut and you can reduce those reflections almost to zero in most cases. If you take that a little bit further and we take that into a studio, we can actually polarise our light sources. So, for example, here I've got two LED light sources. These are ones by Ulanzi, quite little powerful units. Onto that I've mounted a Amazon Basics circular polarising filter. So these are very cheap, I think they were £9 at Amazon, so 52mm filter thread. But it really doesn't matter, just so long as it covers the light bulb that you want to convert into a circular polarised light source. With this filter on this light, it now means that I've got a polarised light source. In fact, if I use two light sources, I can have a main light and a fill light, and I can control the amount of polarisation coming from either of them. So it's useful if you're capturing things like plants, where you want to reduce the sheen from the lights. If you're copying photographs, where normally you'll have a glass in front of it, and you'll find that you're picking up reflections from the room and from your lights. Using a polarised light source at 45 degrees on either side, you can totally eliminate those reflections, as you can see in this picture on screen now. It's also useful if you're photographing product, where you can actually reduce the sheen on your product to virtually zero as well. So this process has quite a few uses in the studio for capturing still life objects. Now, the effect of cross-polarisation comes into play when we have both light sources with a circular polarising filter and a circular polarising filter fitted to our camera lens. Now, in studio use, it really doesn't matter what position this filter is at, as you tend to use the filters on your light source to reduce the reflection. So you just install a circular polariser on your camera lens, and then when your lights are set up on a small tripod, you can then view the image on the back of the camera one light at a time and reduce the reflection to zero on the first light, turn that light off, switch on the other light, again turn the reflections off with that filter, and then just turn the other light on and make your normal exposure. On screen now I'll show you some pictures I've taken using this method. You can see the before and the after on some flowers, and then the before and after on some still life objects, these Lego characters. Again, the before and after the cross-polarisation effect has taken place. The next shot is of the motor cars, and again with and without the cross-polarisation. Again, you can see we've reduced all the reflections from the lights to zero, and we brought out more colour on those cars. And the final shot is where I've copied a photograph. And again, this is behind glass, so you normally see a lot of reflections on there, as you can in the first shot. And then with cross-polarised light sources and the circular polariser on the camera, you can see they've got no reflections, and we've reduced the amount of dust on the glass as well, and we've got a much better picture. In my photographic blog, I'll show you how I've constructed these and what materials you might want to use to make your own cross-polarised light sources, so you can do this sort of photography yourself. You can use any sort of light source, LED or tungsten, even fluorescent light, you can use those as well. You can then use these circular polarising filters to give yourself a circular polarised light source. Now, the stronger the light source, the better, because these will reduce the light by 1.5 stops on each of the lights, plus again about 1.5 stops on the camera. So effectively, we're losing 3 stops of light by using these polarising filters. But because you're on a tripod, the shutter time doesn't really matter. You're actually in control of the exposure. So in my photographic blog, you'll find all the details about how I constructed these, what materials I've used, and other options you've got for constructing lights using sheet material rather than these filters that are available on Amazon. So I hope you'll check that out, and if you're liking what you see here today, there'll be lots more tutorials coming in the future around photography in general. So if you're not already subscribed, why not hit that subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and you'll be advised when you upload those videos. So again, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all in my next video. Goodbye for now.